In this tutorial, we're going to look at inserting an image as a background image in Access 2010 into a form. Now to do this, first of all, you need to get your form up and you need to go to Design View. If you do it in Form View, you won't be able to change the image. You need to go to Design View and be in the view with a nice grid in the background. Get the form roughly to the size you want it to be. And I'm going to show you two different methods of inserting an image. They've both got their sort of positive sides and their drawbacks. And I'll show you the first image, which is a basic copy and paste into Access from the web. So over in the web, I found on sxc.hu the image I want. I checked the image license and it matches what I need to do. I can use it on business related items. So all I do now is I right click on the image, copy the image, go back to Access, and literally just go to home or right click even, and literally paste it in like that. Then I need to make it bigger, so I'll just click in the corner here and drag it out. Now this won't go perfectly the plan because you can see at the moment there's a big white border around it. If you go to size mode here and change it to stretch, it'll fill the screen like that. Zoom doesn't work quite as well because it locks an aspect ratio in zoom, so you might get it not stretching as much in certain directions as you want it to. So stretch I found is the best option. And then all you need to do is click on the image, go to Arrange and Center Back. Now there is a problem that arises quite often here, is that your labels will be the wrong color for the background. Now you can see the labels here are black and gray. The background is black and gray, not a great idea. But you can see here the problem is now that I can't select the labels. And what you've got to do is move the image out of the way, then select the labels, and to change the color of the labels, just go to Format, and you can change to whatever color you want there. And now if I drag the image back, all is well, except for the fact that I've got to shrink the form back down like so. Now that's fine, that's done. I can now save that form, and if I open the form, it'll look fine. Now there is another method of inserting an image in the background. Now I don't like this method as much, but each to their own. If you prefer it, then you can use it. And what I'll do is, first of all, I'll delete the image I put in originally. And this method is slightly different in that you have to save the image first. So first of all, select the form, go over to Form Design Tools, and what we'll be using in a minute is Insert Image. But first of all, I want to get the image I need. So I'll go back to SXC, and this time I'm going to download the image. And what it does, it downloads into a browser window, and you can see the image is huge, a bit too big for my form. So I need to trim that down. So what I'll do is I'll right click, I'll copy the image, and I'll nip over to Paint. Now some people will swear by Paint Shop or Photoshop or Fireworks or even GIMP. I just use Paint because it's easy. And paste the image in like so. And what I need to do now is resize the image, and I'll resize it to about 30% of the original size. And if you maintain the aspect ratio, it'll do it automatically in both, and go to OK. And that image now is much nicer with regard to size. One thing you need to make sure of doing in Paint though is when you resize an image, it does leave a massive white canvas behind. You need to make sure that you trim the canvas down as well, like so. And now I'll just save that, and I'll call it Video Game Background. You can see that I've tested this already, and there's my image now ready to go. So close it down and close that down. Now back into Access, Form Design Tools, click on the form, click on Form Design Tools, Design, Insert Image, and then choose my, go to Browse, go to Pictures, choose the image I want, go to OK, and what I'll do is when you drag, it does exactly the same as we did before. So that's the second method of getting an image in. Again, not ideal. You've got to fiddle around, you've got to save it. And to be honest with you, the copy and paste thing is actually a bit easier. And there is a third method, and again, not the greatest fan of this, but if you go to Format in Form Design Tools, you can put a background image in, and you can browse then, choose the background image, go to OK, and that will then just slap the image in the background. And what is nice about this is you can actually then choose the controls when the image is in the background. So there's three methods there. You've got the copy and paste method, you've got the save image and then insert and just drag the image you want in like that. Some people like doing that for a quick drop of an image, and you've got to save it first. And then finally, you've got the format and background image. So three different methods there of inserting an image into Access. Hopefully you like one of them. I like the first one. You might like the second method of saving, dragging and dropping, and you might just like sticking backgrounds in. Up to you which one you use. We're done.